Hello there, I'm your new neighbor.
To the city.
What's up? It's Master Ace, and I'm on the go, throwing my name up.
Goes one to make you scream,
two to make you shout,
three for the roots,
turn it out, dig it. Yo, I flips and spins on petroleum, because I'm the slicker kid tagging my name in Krylon and Rust-Oleum. Everybody know we am, better they know we are, the S to the TR. Whoops, I forgot to say the A up in the middle, as I groove it just a little, and I rap, it's not a riddle. It is the kid you can't forget, or better you could forget me never, because I'm clever. My shit is mad together, I'm rough as leather. You wonder, whoever or who is it, yet it is the one, Black Thought, the mad exquisite kid to get evicted out the house. Yo, I can't do that, because I am the one that got the versatile, as crazy wild style as rude rap. Yes, it is the new rap, never is it old shit. F's is the bold shit that I kick from the top of the dome. Shit, I better litten. You know I'm not kidding, not forgetting. Way back in the 1, 2, the 9 and 8, 2, the 3, and it was me, and then I was finding, tining my name, a better signing or tagging the shit on the walls, and I was bragging. Hostile dick, except the cops when I hops at stops, the turnstile, then I burn styles, a better burn piles, a better burn files that other MCs be trying to kick in. The styles is ridiculous. Finger licking good, like as if I was fucking chicken. Yes, I am the kid that got the Rhino McDonald, but not down with the Mickin, or better the Big Mackin. I am the abstract versatile kid that's blackin'. Black Thought, the 5 to the foot, 8 inches shorter, just to slaughter MCs. Yo, that be cinches, or better it's a cinch for me to grab the microphone and pinch as I inch up. Then I inch up another inchin'. Yes, I be like lynching like the mob. Yo, I consider it my job just to rock proper slop and hang them and bang them and brutalize them and murder them. Ayo, it's like that, and you know I'm cooler with the E to the S to the P-O and the show on the going. Yes, I be like Cohen all around the place. That's why the bitches be like knowing that I'm like growing, getting hard and longer, cause my styles is mad stronger. Yes, I am Black Daughter, freestyle song performer, and when I'm on her, shit, I'm wild, but sometimes I get calmer. Word to your papa or your mama, I'm a rama. Yo, that is the truth, and I grab the microphone and then I raise the roofing. I'm from the group called The Roots, and it's like that. I step with boots and I grows like fruits.
Green,
and don't stop. Green is what I mean, I'm on the scene. Yo, I am the true gangsta lean.
Pink,
pink, pink, I think I got to go to the sink to wash my hands in. Then I put my mans in.
Blue,
blue, blue, who the hell are you? I am the one that's from The Roots crew, and I'm telling you to rebel.
Steve.
Steve, yes, you know he's gonna leave after he busts a straight on pieces in a
Peach.
Peach, yo, I am the kid that got the speech that you can't impeach, because I am not a leech, I won't
war.
Hang. War, yes, yes, y'all, everybody, as I call you, you got to kick the ball.
Trash.
Trash, the trash is for your ass, it's growing over there, right next to the grass, and then I spaz with you.
Can.
Bam, yo, what did you say? I
can.
Couldn't hear you, my man. Oh, yes, there you go, you said the can. The can's a painting, you know I ain't a Satan, because I am the baddest, the kid that gets the maddest. Yo, you never had this, or better couldn't handle the styles of the kid that's on the go with all the vandals.
Me's.
Me's. Me's, yo nigga, please. I don't wanna talk about those disease. Yo, disease is spread. I grab the microphone, I got the dread, and I kick the shit from the head like that. Hey, you don't stop. Just trip it out.
That's a long enough freestyle for me.
Of the JBs, and I'm on the go. Peace.
About graffiti, is that shit on?
What is it to you, man? What's it mean to you?
What's it mean to me? At first it meant rap, but now I got the rap. It don't really, you know what I mean? I just do it because I like it.
I don't know.
It's hard to say now.
What's it mean to you, man?
I don't know. I express myself with that shit, man.
You be with it forever?
Probably so.
Yeah?
This shit is crazy.
How long you been writing?
I don't know. I used to write TNT back in the day, but, you know, I was messing with Kara since, like, almost 87. And then, you know, I just busted out on the L line and shit. Then I was throwing up straight letters throughout North Philly on the bus routes. And then, I don't know, I'm just here today, bugging
rooftops,
out.
Rooftops your thing?
Yeah, rooftops is my thing. I like to climb. I don't know about this, you know, permission. I don't really get in with permission shit. Because I'd rather be, you know what I mean, like sneaking, doing the shit on a sneaky tip. I like the hassle of being chased and things like that. I don't like, you know what I mean, standing here when I know I don't have to run.
Okay, Smooth Lover here. Word, yo, I'm doing a little something here for the on the go. Okay, player. You know what I'm saying? We're cooling on the original Flavor Block. You know what I'm saying? Fifth and Cortland, you know, this is the original right here. You know, all them back there, they ducks. Yo, come here. Yo, my nigga rolling the fat blunt here. Yo, where the dust bags at? Show them the dust bags. Show them the dust bags. Look at the wet. We got all the wet. All the beer. We gonna get fucked. We just gonna get fucked up. Man, you know what it is, man. That's what we all about. You know what I'm saying? We got all the hip hop booming in the system here. We got all the beer.
I want to get fame. They always talk about fame. I want to get fame. I want to be up all over the city. They would say this is addictive. Whether I get caught again or not, it doesn't matter to me. I will do it again. I will do it again. Whether I get caught again or not, I will do it again.
Yo, can we get some introductions?
Yo, this is Tame One, the Naughty Headed Terror.
And this is Elder Sensei coming at you.
And this is the Artifact shit.
Word gone.
Artifacts.
So what do you guys do?
Well, we call ourselves the... What we call ourselves?
We are the Art of Facts.
Art of Facts.
We are flat black.
Wrong side of the tracks?
Wrong side of the tracks, yeah. That's some old...
That's our graffiti anthem. Let brothers know where we came from, where we at, and where we going.
Some personal type stuff.
And what's up? We bombers here, huh?
Yeah, true. We're trying to represent on the Jersey
I'm
side.
Playing today, but yeah. It's all.
Go home and put some tags up.
A couple of years back, we had the 145th layups. It's me and a couple of niggas from FC. So we're chilling. It's like the wall right here, empty track. The train we was piecing on. Nobody's paying attention late night, you know what I'm saying? We don't give a fuck. It's early Saturday morning. Next thing you know, niggas is like, train. I look back, me being from Jersey, I don't know shit. I looks back and there's a train coming on the only track to hide on. So I see niggas scurrying through in between each train. I say, okay, fuck it. I do the move. We hauling ass down, running. I swear it's the work on behind me. Fucking West. It's West, Zane, some other motherfuckers, I can't remember, I was scared as hell, I was just running. We come up on the platform bright and early Sunday morning, everybody's standing there about to go to church, and here they go. About 17 black Puerto Rican motherfuckers with soot. Jumping up on the turnstile, jumping up through the fucking turnstiles and shit like, oh shit, trying to haul ass. That's a little drama, but.
Yo, so what's up, did you teach Redman? Was he doing this shit on his own?
Yo, all right, just some DL shit. Spark 37, go. Next time you see Redman, ask him who Spark 37 is.
Oh yeah, and that'll put it all in
perspective. I ain't gonna pull his file, just ask him who Spark 37 is and then tell him I told you.
Tracks, the artifacts on the wrong side.
here's a writing tip for you. All you gotta do is pull this tip out, turn it backwards, and you'll get the fat spread on your right. You know what I'm saying?
So this is murder capital of the world, huh? Is that what they tell me?
No.
Is that an exaggeration?
Yeah, very much so.
Why is that? Why do they blow it up so big?
It's a media event, like anything else. It sells newspapers and gets airtime for the media.
Plus the fact it's the nation's capital.
Yeah.
What about graffiti writers? Is there any problems with them?
Not really. We got a few area graffiti writers that are notable, like Cool Disco Dan, and seems to put his touch on every wall.
Yeah, what's up with that?
He seems to make an art up of that. You know, most people don't really appreciate it.
They make him out to be a folk hero, though.
Yeah, they're trying to. But I think that was another media event. They tried to make a folk hero out of it. The style section of the Washington Post.
Yeah.
It actually is vandalism.
Definitely.
You know, I wouldn't want anybody putting any mess on the side of my house that I paid my good money for. You know, I want my house a certain color. Don't come to put anything on it. You know, I'm sure most people feel that way about their property, business, or private.
So that makes your job harder if a guy like Cool Disco Dan is immortalized by the media, huh?
No, it doesn't make my job any harder or any easier. It's just, I don't think it's particularly a fun thing or something to be notarized in the media. Why make a folk hero out of a vandal? And there's nothing new in this, son. Graffiti's been around since time immemorial. The first caveman put his handprint on the wall, that was graffiti.
So what would you say to the graffiti-writing kids of today?
What would I say to them?
Yeah.
Channel the energy somewhere else. Go to a library and read a book. I want art. If you want to be an artist, take an art class. You know, stop defacing other people's property. Get a canvas. You know, go out to the beach and do some sand art. Pablo Picasso did sand art that became very famous. You know, do it like that. You know, why express yourself at the expense of other people? You know, yeah, everybody has rights. This country guarantees you freedom of expression, but it doesn't guarantee you freedom of expression at the expense of other people's freedom.
All right, what's your name?
SMK.
What do you do?
I write graffiti.
And how many times have you been arrested for graffiti?
I've been arrested 7 or 8 times, maybe.
And in how long of a span was this? How much time had passed between?
2 years. They're probably pretty much the first beginning of the graffiti boom in DC.
Are they making an example of you?
They're gonna try to.
Describe the nature of you being arrested. Did they catch you on the street? How did they arrest you?
In 91, they had an eyewitness that saw me do, like, rally on the rooftop. And they called the police, and they caught me going home. I was just walking, right? Like, I had finished off my can, so they didn't find any evidence, so they just arrested me and took me in. A couple times they came to my job and took me from the job, from my work. Now, they had a search and seizure warrant for my house pertaining to any graffiti-related materials, including colored pencils.
Yeah, I've done a lot of good graffiti with them.
Yeah, I've bombed a lot of trains with colored pencils and did some nice fill-ins with them, too.
So you've lost everything.
Yeah, but I went to court today, as a matter of fact.
And how did that go?
The end result is I got locked up again today.
Yeah, so what's up with your magazine?
They took all the cut and paste up originals. I had the latest issue I had. I think I had 40, 50 copies in my house. They took all those. I don't know what's up with them. I don't know. They're going to give it back. They have to, because it doesn't, I mean, they're trying to use it as evidence against me in court. But it's not going to work, because I ain't going out like that.
Have your rights been violated?
My civil rights, I believe, yeah.
Do you think you can recover financial losses that you have lost here?
Not unless I get a good lawyer.
Have you considered going to the law firm of Espo and Mies?
I've given it good consideration, and I might just give them a call tomorrow.
Okay, do that. Okay, I want you to say, I'm SMK and I'm in jail.
Over.
So what's up? You don't like graffiti magazines, huh?
Nope.
That shit's kind of like commercial, huh?
Shit.
Sucks, man. See enough graffiti out on the streets.
Graffiti is all about writing. That's it.
Yeah, it's all about who got respect and fame.
Yeah? What about Carson Rez? They got respect and fame?
They got mad respect.
Could you give us a little bit of background? Who you are and what you've done in the graffiti scene?
I've been writing graffiti for, I guess, since 1981 officially. I did trains, I've done throw-ups, I got mad tagging style, but most kids don't know that. I used to bomb the BMTs with a bunch of other guys, including Cost. And now we're here for the real mission.
What's the real mission?
Taking things over. We want to take over the city, eventually the country, and finally the world.
Andy Warhol, do you think they really wreck shit out here?
Yeah, they get their props. You know, they were doing shit, you know, 10, 15 years ago. They're dead now.
Are there pressures from the outside trying to slow you down?
There's always pressure.
There's a conspiracy to stop us. And we're not going for it because they can't subdue the public voice.
The art world wants to subdue us, the police want to, and also the graffiti guys. They want to shun us and say that we're doing bad things.
See, we're not here to critique everybody, you know, because we're not art critics. We're the same as the other guy in the street walking down, you know. We got no credentials to give somebody a critique and tell them whether they're good or not.
So you guys are the blue-collar artists.
You could say that. That's very good. Yeah, that hits it kind of on the nose almost. Nice weather.
Have you ever had any skirmishes with the law?
Oh, all the time, ever since I was born.
Well, what we have right here, in Fat Lip's hand, well, his other hand, is a tape called On the Go. And it's all about graffiti and the art of running away from the police.
Very underground.